In this video, you will see how to license Amazon Redshift serverless data shares with AWS Data Exchange. With this solution, you can create AWS Data Exchange data shares to license custom datasets and share them with customers. Before getting started, let's review a few prerequisites. This AWS Identity and Access Management, or IAM role, has been configured with the permissions we'll need throughout this demo. A second IAM role has been configured to allow Redshift clusters to call AWS services on your behalf. Finally, an Amazon S3 bucket has been created with a folder containing the data we'll load into our database. Now let's open the AWS console to get started. To begin, we'll open the Amazon Redshift serverless dashboard to create a workgroup for the data share. Amazon Redshift Serverless is a serverless option of Amazon Redshift that makes it easy to run and scale analytics in seconds without the need to set up and manage data warehouse infrastructure. Let's give our workgroup a name. We can adjust the computing capacity depending on our performance needs. In this case, we'll use the default. Next, we'll add a namespace, which is a collection of database objects and users. The default database name can't be changed, but once our workgroup is created, we can create a new database if needed. Let's customize the admin user credentials. Under permissions, we'll associate an IAM role. Let's choose the data share role we created as a prerequisite. Now let's review the configuration and create the workgroup. It will take a few minutes to create. Let's refresh the dashboard. The namespace and workgroup are both available. Now let's open the Redshift query editor to load data into Redshift. We'll create a connection to the database we created. Let's create a new schema. Next, we'll run a query to create a table for our dataset. In a new tab, we'll copy data from our S3 bucket into the table. Let's run a test query to ensure all the data loaded properly. The data loaded successfully. Now let's return to the Amazon Redshift serverless console and create a data share. We'll use the AWS Data Exchange data share type. Let's name the data share and use the default database we created earlier. Next, let's add the schema and table that we created. Now let's create the data share. Our data share has been created and shared. Now let's go to AWS Data Exchange to create a data set. We'll select the Amazon Redshift data share type. Let's provide a name and description for the data set. Next, we'll add our data share. Now let's review and finalize the data set. The first revision of our data set has been created. You've just seen how to license Amazon Redshift serverless data shares with AWS Data Exchange. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.